Welcome to Digital Electronics Lecture Series. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you how to identify minimal decimal equivalent of given number, right? And this is quite tricky question. So you will get to know after few examples. So here first I'm giving you question. So question is, to identify minimal decimal equivalent of this system, and here base is not given. So sometimes what you do is, like, you will be translating this system into decimal by considering this is hexadecimal system, but as if you do that, in that case your answer will be completely false. Why? The reason is you cannot consider this system as hexadecimal system, right? As base is not given. So this is the basic mistake which I have seen students are doing. They don't see the base, they directly consider this is hexadecimal system and they convert this into decimal and they consider that is minimal decimal equivalent, right? But here first agenda, that has to be identification of base. So how to identify base for minimal decimal equivalent? So basic identification of base, that we can have it by having maximum digit which is given in this number, plus 1. So that is how we identify base of this given number. So here maximum digit is D, and if you see, this D is equivalent to 13, and 13 plus 1, that will be base for minimal decimal equivalent, right? So maximum digit is D, that is 13, plus 1, so that is 14, and 14 is a base to have minimal decimal equivalent for this given number. So now we can consider this base to have minimum decimal equivalent of this number. So now we can have minimal decimal equivalent, and that we can have it by having consideration of this number with base of 14. So in that situation, this D, that is 13 into 14 to the power 2 plus this 1 into 14 to the power 1 plus 7 into 14 to the power 0, right? And if you solve this, you can have minimal decimal equivalent. So that will be 13 into 14 square plus 14 plus 7. So that is 2569. So this is my minimal decimal equivalent of this given number without having knowledge of any base, right? So base can be greater than 14 for this number. So if you consider base is greater than 14, in that case minimum decimal equivalent will increase, right? So that is the case which will happen. So let me explain you that how it will increase. Like, see, this is the base which we have considered, and that is 14, right? But if I say base is 16 without having knowledge, right, then in that situation this equivalent, in that situation, that equivalent, that will be 13 into 16 square plus 1 into 16 plus 7 into 16 to the power 0. And if you solve this in this way, then you will be finding that is 13 into 16 square plus 16 plus 7. So that is 3351. So you see, this number is greater than this number. So minimal decimal equivalent, that is based on what is minimum base which is there with this given number. So minimum base with this given number is D plus 1. So D is 13 plus 1, that is 14. Let us have a few more questions, so it will be giving you more resolution. So next question is, find minimal decimal equivalent of 731x. So here first I need to identify base, and for minimal decimal equivalent, base should be maximum digit plus 1. So here maximum digit of 731 is 7. So maximum digit plus 1, that is the basic formula where maximum digit is 7 plus 1. So this base is 8 for minimum decimal equivalent. So we will be having minimal decimal equivalent for this question, and that will be 7 into 8 to the power 2 plus 3 into 8 to the power 1 plus 1 into 8 to the power 0. And if you solve this, then that will be 7 into 8 square plus 3 into 8 plus 1. So that is 473. So this is what minimal decimal equivalent, 473, for this given number. Now let us have one more question. So now that will resolve this session completely, and after that I'll give you some practice questions. So third question for this session is, so here question is given, find minimal decimal equivalent of 3241x. And as I have told you, we need to identify base of minimal equivalent decimal, and that equation of base, that is maximum digit plus 1. So here just check out for maximum digit. So maximum digit is 3241. So 4 is maximum digit. So I can say 4 plus 1. So that is 5. So base 5, that is there for minimum decimal equivalent of this. So here we can have minimal decimal equivalent and we can resolve this by 3 into 5 to the power, now see 4 digits are there, so 5 to the power 3 plus 2 into 5 to the power 2 plus 4 into 5 to the power 1 plus 1 into 5 to the power 0. And if you solve this, we can have minimal decimal equivalent of this question. So 3 into 5 cube plus 2 into 5 square plus 4 into 5 plus 1. So that is 446. Right, so this is what minimal decimal equivalent. And if you have more than that base, in that case this decimal equivalent will increase. So minimal decimal equivalent for this number, that is this, right? And I have told you, like, see, initially if you increase base, then that equivalent will increase for this number, right? So first we need to identify what has to be the base which will be the least base of that equivalent, and least base, that will be maximum digit plus 1, and then we need to substitute that base into that equivalent by just multiplying power of that base with individual digits and add it, and that will result into minimal decimal equivalent of that given number. So that is the basic process. Now I'll give you some homework question. And in this homework question, you are little bit to identify minimal decimal equivalent. So homework question is, for given numbers, where first number is 3162 with x base, g6 with x base, 11 with x base. So you write your answers in comments. Definitely I'll get back to you if any query is there. Now there can be question like, I have written g6, so how to identify g can be identified as per ABCD. So ABCDEFG, so 10 11 12 13 14 15 16. So 16 plus 1, 17 will be the base of this. So that is how we need to understand, and then we need to find minimal equivalent decimal for an equation. So please write your answers in comment. Definitely I'll get back to you if any query has been there. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos that will resolve your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.